I'm Christine Dunbar from SpeechModification.com, and this is my Smart American Accent Training. Welcome to our Word of the Day series, where I've been taking your requests for words you'd like help to pronounce in American English. Today, we're going to cover quite a few words in this class because there have been so many great requests, and I'm still working on requests that came in November and December, and it's already February, so thank you for waiting patiently for me to get to your word, and thank you everyone who's given me great suggestions. You can get your words answered more quickly if you would like to attend our Friday live question and answer classes. There you can make your requests right in the chat and I'll answer them live. Also, our channel members can ask questions at any time, and I do a class once a week that's just for members where I cover their words. We can talk live and answer questions and help you live, as well as if you can't make to the live class, I'll still be covering your words. So consider joining the channel if that's helpful to you. And otherwise, let's go proceed with our regular word of the day for today. So our words for today will be victory, copy, print out, cocky and khaki, logistics and supply chain, and absolutely. And on first glance, it doesn't really look like these words have a lot to do with each other, but even in selecting these words, I was able to see quite a few patterns of pronunciation and potential error patterns that come from speaking English as a second or third language. So I'll highlight those as we go. First, looking at some of our words, copy, cocky, khaki, absolutely. These all end with the tense E sound. We often spell that with letter I in the, here's the exception, I mean with letter Y, here's the exception spelling it with letter I. And what happens for these sounds is often when you get to the end of the word, you may have a tendency to use more of an I or an sound there because it's not important, it's unstressed and fast. And it's interesting because the E sound is usually not an error for you just in everyday words like eat and need. But when it comes here at the end of the word, sometimes it's hard, especially in words like city or pretty, where we have an I and an E together. We've talked about that quite a bit in words like quality, quantity, that end words that end with I-T-Y. At any rate, watch out for that, and we'll talk about that. In victory, we have first syllable stress, and there's really two different ways that you'll hear native speakers say this word. They'll either say victory with three syllables, long, short, short, victory, or they'll say it more like victory, victory, where that tree at the end gets a little bit squished together, almost like just one syllable, victory. So that would look more like Vic tree. And you might find that easier rather than victory, victory. Whichever one is easier for you is what you should go for. Just make sure that your Vic syllable is long and your tree or tree syllable at the end is short. It has a lax I vowel. And then we have, of course, the letters OR say more of an ER sound, or else that O just drops and we go right to tree. Then when we look at copy, we also have an E, first syllable stress, and an unstressed quick tense E at the end. Copy, looks like I forgot, oh here, yeah, we have the letter, the sound ah for the letter O. So just like in coffee, well coffee is an ah, never mind. Copy, just like in cop or hot, has an ah sound and then an E sound, long and short. That would be my alternate spelling. So as you have been seeing in the Word of the Day videos, I typically give you the IPA, International Phonetic Alphabet, as well as a way of rewriting the word if it's helpful for you to visualize what the sounds are in the word. In my new free Word of the Day online course, we have the videos that you're watching here on our Word of the Day series, as well as the definitions for the words and some links for more information from some good dictionary sources. So if you haven't yet checked that out on speechmodification.com, it's new, it's totally free. It's just an online course that is an assemblance, a congregation of these many wonderful Word of the Day videos that you've requested. What I like about it is you can also search alphabetically, find your word, and I have some special lists in that course of words that are often more challenging or words that I often hear mispronounced. So check it out, speechmodification.com. Along with copy, we also had a request for a printout. And for this one, it depends on if you're talking about a noun, like a printout, something that we printed out, then you're going to stress the first syllable and it'll sound like print out. Or if you're using it as a verb phrase, I'm going to print something out, print that out, then we stress on out. So noun, print out, verb, print out. Please print out the document. He handed me a printout. This O-U-T is just like the word out, and you'll often hear that Americans don't say the T's very clearly in something like print out. I might either say print out where I use that T, or print out. Sometimes we drop that T a little bit and stop that final one. I think it's probably clearer to use the T, print out, but you'll hear both. Then the next pair was requested together. It was the words cocky versus khaki. And all we're looking at here is the difference between the vowels. So letter O in cocky is going to say the ah vowel. That's the IPA. I rewrite it as AH to help you think about that open back vowel, ah. And then again, there's our lax little unstressed, still tense, but unstressed E. And then khaki, we have the black cat vowel, and usually I just write that with letter A. It's like the vowel in cat. If you have trouble, anytime you have trouble between two words that are very similar, where maybe the only difference is a vowel sound, often I think it's helpful to pair those words with another word with the same vowel. So for example, I might try thinking about not cocky or cocky father. So I have that ah vowel in both versus a khaki cat or khaki pants. Those both have the ah vowel. Okay, my board's getting pretty crowded, huh? Now let's move on to the next request was for the phrases logistics and supply chain. And I just actually said that with a low logistics, but when I'm using it in connected speech, I'm really going to use more of a schwa there, and it'll sound like la, because my stress is on j. So this is a letter G that says the J sound, and I have a lax I vowel, logistics. Because that T comes after the S and it doesn't start a stressed syllable, logistics, I am saying a true T there, but I don't really have to do a strong T, logistics. ST blends tend to have kind of a more muted T at logistics. And then the S does say S at the end of this word because K is voiceless. Then when we get to supply chain, here's another example, just like printout, supply chain, where I want my main stress on supply and then a little secondary stress on chain. So it's a compound noun, and in compound nouns, whether they're one word or two words, we stress the first word of the two more. So supply will actually really be stressing on the ply part because the first syllable of supply is unstressed. So it sounds like su. And then my ply, that y doesn't do the e like these other y's. It does the diphthong I. So just like the word I am, I have, supply. Chain, we have the letter ch, which typically say the sound ch, written like this. And then we have our tense A, make sure you hold your A long enough. Supply chain, logistics and supply chain. And finally, we'll cover the word absolutely. We absolutely will. We have this main stress on the lute syllable. Secondary stress probably here on this A, black cat vowel. Absa, absolutely. So it sounds like ab, we have a schwa, absolute. Here we use a stopped T, absolutely, where I go to make that T, but I don't release it out. Not absolutely, but absolutely. I just release it right into the L. And then another Y that says my tense E sound at the end. So, okay, sorry, my board is so full today. I'm not doing a very good job of showing it to you. I apologize if you had any trouble following along with so many words in one class, but as I was mentioning at the beginning of class, I do want to try to make sure that you know your word is coming if you've made a request. I do have a running list. I have many, many requests that have come in, so it may be a little while before you see your word. Do try to come to our Friday live question and answer classes to get your information quicker, or you can join the channel as a member, and I'll cover your words every Sunday in our live members class. Thanks so much for those of you who have joined the channel as channel members, and for the many of you who've been signing up for the Word of the Day course on speechmodification.com. It's a free course with these same Word of the Day videos as well as definitions for the words. It's great to see all of you there. I hope you'll be back with me again tomorrow with our next Word of the Day class, as well as on Friday with our live question and answer class. I'm Christine Dunbar from speechmodification.com. Remember, if you want to sound like a native speaker, you can do it. Speechmodification.com. Bye, guys. See you tomorrow.